It was a great day to be Italian-American and in the Bronx. Chairman of the Brooklyn Democratic Party, Frank Seddio, was one of four honorees at Bronx Borough President Ruben Diaz Jr.'s annual Italian-American Heritage event at Schiff Hall in the Bronx Zoo. Growing up the son of immigrants from Sicily, he talked about his childhood in Canarsie.
And to this day, I remember that one time when I got promoted to the adult table as I was 13 years old and got the chance to sit with my family.
Being Italian-American, just it's the whole thing about tradition and family.
And in the Bronx, she's co-owner of S&K Bistro, the borough's only French restaurant located on City Island. Maria Caruso shared family photos dating back to the turn of the last century with her mother immigrating from Naples and settling on the Lower East Side. She would marry and move to the Bronx. Orchard Beach was a popular spot, and they lived in the Monroe houses.
My cousins and I are like more than just cousins. We feel like sisters and brothers. And we, from very young age, just bonded together and spent all the holidays together.
He came here when he was 9 years old.
And his grandfather immigrated from Popoli. William Mayer, owner of Maestro's Caterers, has been there for thousands of celebrations over the decades. Loyal customers include the Reverend Ruben Diaz Sr. And while a teen, Diaz Jr. shared that Eastwood Manor, also owned by the family, was where he and his wife shared their first date.
We're pleased to serve the community, pleased to be part of the Bronx, especially pleased, and very proud of my Italian heritage.
I'm an Italian-American and very proud of it.
Many Italian immigrants who came to this country worked as masons. It's something that New York City Councilman Jimmy Vaca's father did before he lost his vision. It's something that built a bond between them as Vaca became his eyes and early on developed a love for service.
Well, when I was in the eighth grade at my junior high school, 101 in Throgs Neck, the number 5 Bruckner Boulevard bus never came. So I organized the students in my junior high school to fight the MTA. And we organized, we won, we got petitions, we went to the elected officials.
Due to the humanitarian crisis in Puerto Rico, Diaz Jr. missed this year's Columbus Day Parade to travel by plane to deliver aid. Tonight he expressed his joy in recognizing the Bronx's Italian-American community and all that they do to bring good to the borough.
They came here, they moved to this part of the Bronx, they helped build the Bronx. They helped build the Lions House here in the Bronx Zoo. They created a community nearby in Arthur Avenue, which is Belmont, which is Little Italy.
The evening, hosted by News 12's Gianna Gelosi, also included remarks from the Italian Heritage and Culture Committee of New York and the Consul General of Italy, Francesco Gionardi.
This year, we're honoring Italian Americans in cinema and theater, which is a salute to actors and directors.
Perfect words to end a perfect evening here at Schiff Hall. This is Arlene McCoco for BronxNet Television.